On behalf of Pastor and Lady Ming and the Retrieve Your Life family, we welcome you to Retrieve Your Life Ministries, a church that is looking up, reaching out, and caring for all. Let's join today's service, which is already in progress.
Good morning, Retrieve Your Life Ministries.
Good morning.
Good morning, Retrieve Your Life Ministries.
Good morning. Good morning.
Okay, that's a little better. Second week in January 2017, God has saw fit to allow us to see another week. If that's not enough to give praise and honor to Him for, I don't know what is. It's interesting we're learning about praise and worship because today it seems to be sorely lacking. And I'm not saying that we don't praise and worship, but we don't do enough of it. Don't worry about the person next to you. Don't worry about what somebody gonna say. Give God praise. Give God worship. Because they may not know. And those who don't know and refuse to worship, God gonna take care of it, him or her. Just do what you got to do. If you call yourself a child of God, you call yourself a Christian, you need to have praise and worship on your lips all the time. Amen. Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Who has set thy glory above the heavens? Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightest steal the enemy and the avenger. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and stars, which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? That's Psalm chapter 8, verses 1 through 4. So today, when we give God praise and worship, remember those verses. When you consider the heavens, the work of thy fingers, would you just open that door right outside and look? Look at your life. Who is man that God loves us so much that he takes care of us, he provides our needs and some of our desires? He loved us so much that he sent his son to take away our sins so we can have a relationship with God the Father. If that's not enough to give him praise and glory this morning, you got problems. And I'm not saying you got to get there today, but just work on that, amen? That's your call to worship today. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Give him the praise and glory.
Father, whatever it is that's ailing her right now, God, we ask that you deliver her, Lord Jesus. Heal her body right now, God. Give her strength, Lord Jesus. God, we ask that you guide the doctors and the nurses, Father God. Have godly people surrounding her as she endures whatever she's going through, Lord. Lord, we ask that you just be with our whole entire church family, Father God. Bless those that are in need, Father God. Those that have, Father God, I ask that you give them a heart to give, Lord Jesus. God, we just thank you for all things right now, Lord. Lord, we ask that you forgive us for sins, Father God. Forgive us for the things that we've done that have been unpleasing to your sight, Lord. Lord, we just thank you for all things. We give you praise, glory, and honor in your precious Son, Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. My life in this place. You know, we get an opportunity to live our lives in this place. But it all depends on your choices that you make on how you live in this place. This place is not forever. This place is gonna, you know, it's like you get a car. You can only drive it for so long, and eventually it's gonna start breaking down. Eventually it starts getting into your pocket. And
And then you start, you know, you really don't want a car note, but eventually you have to say, you know, I just got to break on down, just give me something new. And, you know, that just lets you know that everything gets old. And it breaks down. And that's why, you know, you got to live your life right now in this place. Stop trying to live for tomorrow. Stop trying to live for yesterday. We need to be living for today in this place. Because you're not going to be here forever. You know, has anybody ever seen a NASCAR race? You know, when at a NASCAR, you know, they have to make a pit stop, right? You know, they can go around the track so many times, but they got to stop and make a pit stop. You know, they got to get the tires changed, got to get some gas, you know, what they clean the windows and everything, give them something to drink or it's hot. But they have to make a pit stop, and they get back in the race. It's the same way with life. Every now and then, you got to make a pit stop in this place. You know, you got to get something changed in this place. You know, some of us, we don't even want to get our tires changed. You need to get your tires changed, you need to get your windows washed, you need to get your mouth washed. We need a whole lot of stuff cleaned up. And that's why, you know, when you think about this place, think about this is not your permanent place. It's just a pit stop along the way. But along the way, make sure you make your pit stops to get the necessary things that you need in this life, in this place. You need the word. You need to know how to love. You need to be kind, caring. You need to be giving. All these things you can pick up at your pit stop along the way. But some of us, you know, we like some of the drivers. We turn away, we don't think we need no new tires right now, so we're going to try to drive around about 30 more laps around the track. Then you get a blowout and you spin it around. Life has a lot of things to throw at you in this place. Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
January 7th. 2017, ain't it amazing, gentlemen? You know, in just a few minutes, we're gonna be talking about, man, it's summertime, it's almost winter again. Amen. Yeah, I think I'm kidding. You're gonna wake up and it's gonna be June the 20th.
I wish you were tomorrow.
Amen. We got Kevin Hart now. You know, this great opportunity that God gives us, we got to take advantage of it. Not of Him, but the opportunities that He places before us. I can't speak for everybody. I don't know about you all, but I'm just trying to do the right things by God that God wants me to do. You know, it's amazing that people think that, you know, the pastor is supposed to do A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. But that torch gets hit. And you know, sometimes, you know, you guys got to just give it to the Lord. You can't carry every bird. You can't carry every problem. You just got to give it to the Lord. You got to learn to just give things to God and let it be. And let Him do what He gonna do. I'm just grateful and thankful that I'm in that place where things just not bother me like they used to. And those I say like they used to. And then, you know, I'm just going to stop right there. I'm going to go on, because I'm not going to get on y'all nerves. And y'all going to talk about me a little bit, but that's all right. God got me, even if you don't. So you know how we do it all YLM? A minister, that's me, told his congregation, next week I plan to preach about the sin of lying. And we got any liars out here? Amen. Amen. Ain't nobody gonna raise their hand on them. So to help you understand my sermon, I want all of you to read Mark chapter 17. Amen. And the following Sunday, as he prepared to deliver his sermon, the minister asked for a show of hands. He wanted to know how many people had read Mark 17. Every hand in the house went up. The minister just smiled. And he said, Mark only has 16 chapters. Oh my. I will now proceed with my sermon on the sin of lying. Amen. Amen. Read your word. So you don't get caught up. Say it like you mean it.
This is my Bible. This is my God. Word of God. In whom I will trust.
Amen. Yes, you know we're starting this series on Isaiah 2017 New Year's cleanup. And we're in Isaiah chapter 1, verses 10 through 20. And I'm not going to reread it because you should have already been reading this along the way because you knew chapter 2 was coming. So, we're going to pick up chapter 2 today on 2017 New Year's cleanup. Now, we talked about we need to clean up and where there's frequent attendance and whatever, many times at worship through 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we're going to pick up, I'm at number 5, where we need to clean up when there are many prayers, but a God who will not hear. Amen? You see, you understand, one of the things, here in this chapter of Isaiah, although the people of Judah were very religious, like some of us are, we claim to be very religious, they were accused of being as evil as the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. And you know, people, we can't be as evil as some of the people in Sodom and Gomorrah. Amen. We won't admit it, but we know we can be some evil folks.
Mm-hmm. Amen. You ain't gonna devil get nobody to say amen when you're talking about it.
You know what I'm saying? They gave sacrifices to pay for their sins, but they felt no remorse. They needed to take more inventories, acknowledge the depth of their sins, and turn to God for cleansing and renewal. Religious activity, you all, is no substitute for a genuine life with God. It is only when we honestly confess our sins and ask God to help us that he will make us as clean as freshly fallen snow. We had a little snow this week, didn't we? And as the snow was falling, it looked fresh. It was just soaked. It was just pure, just crystal clean white. Until man steps all in it and makes it dirty. We sure know how to mess something up, don't we? You see it falling from the sky and it's fresh and it's clean and it's pure. But as soon as man gets his hands on it, it's like your sin. You got to know how to clean up when there are many prayers but a God who will not hear. And in verse 15, Isaiah said, from now on, when you lift up your hands in prayer, I will refuse to look. Well, this is Isaiah's book, but it's God speaking. Even though you offer many prayers, I will not listen. For your hands are covered with blood of your innocent victims. How many of us have committed murder?
Amen.
And not even know it. When and why does God hear our prayers? Because the children of Israel had bloody hands. And therefore God did not listen to them. And therefore sometimes God doesn't listen to you. The children of Israel did not necessarily literally kill someone, just like us. We're not literally going out and killing someone. But our actions brought about the same results. Come on, somebody help me with something this morning.
Come on, Pastor. Come on.
We don't need to kill someone, you all, to have bloody hands.
Amen.
If you are angry with a brother or sister without a cause, you're guilty of the equivalent of murder. Red Room.
Oh. This is something y'all gotta watch. Everybody gotta know what I'm talking about. You gotta keep up with it. You gotta keep up with it. Red Room, Red Room.
Murder spelled backwards. If you commit character assassination, you are displeasing God. How many character assassinations have you committed lately? Come on, help me somebody. This morning, if you hold a grudge, a root of bitterness against someone, you are falling and failing to apply the grace of God to your life. Not the individual you hold a grudge against, to your own life. You can hold all the grudges you want against me. Because you're not hurting me. You hurt your own life, not mine. You don't want to speak to me? Praise the Lord. All right. You angry with me? God bless you. You don't like me no more? Hallelujah. I'm still living. You're the one that's got the issue. You're the one that's not going to have the grace of God in your life, not me.
Teach, Pastor, teach.
Because this grudge, I'm telling you, it's going to trouble you, and also it's going to trouble those around you. See, that's why I refuse to let people with their troubles try to put their troubles on me. I'm not carrying your troubles with me. I got enough troubles of my own.
All right.
And because you got a grudge or you angry with me and you want me to carry that, the devil is alive, not today. It's 2017, y'all. We need a New Year's cleanup. Get rid of your resolutions, because all of them, they lies anyway. You know you're not keeping them. I'm going to lose 20 pounds by the end of February. You know, you're going to gain 20 by the end of January. We got to stop. Let me tell you something. We got to get real with this thing. Let me put it this way. It's about to get real. I don't know about you, but God is real, and God is tired of playing with his people. Just like is anybody paying attention to Isaiah? You know what he did to the people of Israel, to the people of Judah. What makes you any different? Amen. And let me tell you something else. This church is hurting because some of you are holding grudges against others in this congregation. I know how I clap for myself. And some of these grudges have gone on for years. We have cleaned up when we heed God's call to repentance. How many of us are going to repent and confess and wash you and make you clean? How can he do any of those things if you're going around holding grudges? It's time for a cleanup. Get out your brooms. Start sweeping some stuff away and forsake. And let me tell you something. You got to put away the evil of your doings. Amen.
Amen.
You got to put them evil things, you got to put them away. Let me read something to you. Verse 16, he said, wash yourselves and be clean. I can really stop right there. Because he didn't say, let me wash you. He said, wash yourselves and be clean. That's what the Lord said. And he said, let me no longer see your evil deeds. Keep on doing this foolishness you're doing. See where it's going to get you. He said, give up your wicked ways. I don't know who you're talking to, Lord, but I'm going to keep on going with this. Because, of course, we ought to forsake our sin, but we must also put away the evil of our doing from before God's eyes. Don't you know that everything you're doing, don't you know all that evil, that grudge, the anger, don't you know that's right before God's eyes? You losing your mind because you're in a rage, but God is seeing everything you're doing. And then we want to shout hallelujah, praise, thank you, Jesus. For real. We need a cleanup. Some of us need an operation.
Amen.
You know, we need a new heart. We need a heart transplant. We need a liver transplant. We need kidney. Look at we just need a transplant. Clean me up. But he had told you to wash yourself. Because he don't want to see your evil deeds no more. God is tired. God's tired. I'm tired. You tired. You should be. Need to wake up and look and say, you know what? I need to evaluate some stuff. Because let me tell you something. This means that what we need to do, we need to make right with others what we have already done wrong. Hey, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because there are times when we must confess sins to others. We have to. There are times when we're going to have to seek the forgiveness of others. See, we let that, you know, you let that pride in the way right there. That's where pride takes over. We got to learn to do well, you all. And verse 17 he said, learn to do good. Seek justice. Help the oppressed. Defend the orphan. Fight for the rights of widows. You can't do none of that because you too busy having grudges. You too angry. You too upset. You all in a hissy fit. You can't do nothing the Lord wants you to do because you in the way of you. We must learn to do well, you all, because our sins must be replaced with positive actions and attitudes, especially towards those we have hurt in the past. Oh, help me somebody. I'm here to seek justice. That is which is right and fair to all. I'm here to relieve those who are physically and spiritually oppressed. I don't know about you, but I hope somebody listening this morning. I'm here to seek the well-being of the fatherless and the widow, those who are down and out or not to be exploited, but helped. And how can we help anyone that's been exploited if we're one doing all the exploiting? All right. We have clean up when we accept God's invitation for cleansing. We're going to talk about the work of God. Because in Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 18, he said, come. Now, let us argue this out, says the Lord. No matter how deep the stain of your sins, guess what? I can remove it. I can make you as clean as freshly fallen snow, the same snow we were just talking about. Even if you are stained as red as crimson. You know that murder y'all doing all that blood? I can make you as white as wool. That's what the Lord says. God is saying to you all, come to court with me. Let's reason together. Here he implies that we ought to repent to do as he says. God is, think about it, he's asking you and he's trying to give you a way out. He's trying to help you to help yourself. He said, come to court with me. I'm going to forgive you and I'm going to clean you up. But you got to be willing to come to me. If you're going to stay in that place you are right now with Satan, there's not really much I can do for you. I can, because nothing, there's nothing I cannot do. I can help you, but I need to see you fight your way out of this. I need you to come to me. I'm already with you. I don't need to come to you. Sometimes we have to listen to the Lord. Amen. We have to learn how to repent and do what these verses was telling us in 16 and 17. Well, he no longer wants to see our evil deeds. Well, we have to give up our evil ways. Well, he wants us to learn to do good, seek justice. These are the things God wants us to do, and we have got to just do it. I'm going to use that Nike logo right now. Stop being stubborn. Stop being selfish. Just do it. Do what the Word of God says. Isaiah the prophet. Oh, what a great, great, great man. God chose this man. Did any of y'all know that Isaiah had a family? had two sons. Even his sons were given up to God. Isaiah just dropped everything he did that he had to do what the Lord told him to do, to go prophesy to the people of Israel. And each and every week, God sends people to each and every last one of you to tell you something that he wants you to do, and we don't pay him no attention. You don't know who's speaking to you. You don't know who you're entertaining.
Amen. So true.
You really don't. And I'm just, God says, through your sins, I mean, though your sins be as scarlet, like a red dye made from the worms, he will make them as white as snow. Your sins can be as red as, but you know all that murder you'd have committed. He telling you, I can make them as white as snow. I can make it pure if you just follow me. If you just give up your evil ways. Stop doing the things that you know are not good. We have to stop being evil, you all, towards one another. We really do. We got, let me tell you something. We have to stop all this foolishness of being angry with one another, being angry with people. Holding the grudge. Let that stuff go. You're only hurting yourself. You're not hurting the other individual. The God already told you, you're hurting you. Stop hurting yourself. I stopped hurting myself a long time ago because I figured it out. I ain't caring nobody else's stuff no more. I used to carry stuff so much that I started having pains in my chest and heart, you know, what they call anxiety attacks and all this kind of attack. Man, please. In the hospital, chest pain, don't know why I'm having them. Because I was selfish, holding grudges, pissed off as they call it. Got to let that stuff go. It's going to kill you. I hope y'all know that anxiety can't kill you.
Amen.
It really can. You think you're having a heart attack, and you will die from it. Got to let stuff go, you all. He also told us that our sins be as crimson as a red-colored cloth, and he will make them as white as wool. That is like a miracle to make a red of all colors into a pure white. Can you imagine, you know, have you ever seen that commercial with the oxy, what's that name of that stuff? What's the name of that stuff?
OxyClean.
And the man, it's like ink in the water or something, and it's like black or red or whatever it is, and he pours that OxyClean in and serves around it, and it becomes white and just like crystal clear pure. That's what God wants to do with your life. Because see, we already know we dirty. Amen. We know we dirty. We know we committed murder. Some of y'all committed murder on the way down here. Amen. Murderers! That's what you are. Red rum. Don't nobody start riding a little tricycle up and down the aisle. So how can God make such a promise to us, you all? Easy, because it is because God washed the sins of believers away at the cross. When he washed everybody's sins away at the cross, that's how he did it. And you know what? We're so selfish, we don't even take advantage of that. We're not even grateful for it. Because we still acting like those folks back 2,000, 3,000 years ago. We still acting like the Israelites.
Amen.
We're acting just like them. We don't even realize it. It's 2017 and we haven't learned anything. We might as well be back in 700 A.D. Why not? We're doing the same thing they're doing. Only thing changes is people in the ears. That's it. Same principles, same philosophies, same anger against one another. I want you to know that this year,
God can cleanse you from every sin and make you fit to worship. Not only like last week on New Year's Day, but every day. Every day. But the thing about it is, are you willing to be cleansed? Are you willing to let God cleanse you today? It's 2017, New Year's, and we are in dire need of a cleanup. And it's not just Retrieve Your Life Ministries. It's everybody. Everybody got a will. Who in here is willing to be obedient, to confess, forsake, and make things right with others? Who ready to do that right now today?
Amen.
Look within your own self. Look deep within your heart. And confess. And make things right with somebody. You got a lot of people that you've probably been at, that you're angry with right now. Stop carrying that. It's going to hurt you. It's going to hurt you. And if you're willing to be obedient, you will prosper spiritually. See, we got to get out this physical thing. We got to get out this physical realm we in. We caught up in this physical realm. We got to start thinking spiritually. You're going to be able to worship, and God will accept and be pleased with your worship when you are right spiritually. When you ain't right spiritually, don't you know that God ain't, that's why he already told you, he don't hear. He don't hear you. He ain't listening to your prayers. You think he is. You praying, but you all jacked up. You praying, but you angry. God ain't listening to you. You think he is. I'm going to pray the Lord. The Lord always hear. He listens to all of us. Yeah, he listens. And he said, I ain't say he didn't listen. He's not hearing what you're saying. I can listen to you and turn you and tune you out. How many times have y'all done that? Somebody talking to you, you just don't pay them no attention. It's just one ear and out the other. Did a lot of times with your parents. Amen.
Amen.
They just tell you something all the time. It's just going one ear and out the other because you weren't paying no attention. We can't sit here and lie about it. I know I did. A whole lot of times. My mom, because I'm like, I don't know what she's talking about. She don't know what she's talking about. Who she talking to? But I won't tell her that. You know what I'm saying? Because I got jacked up. I'm just saying, you all. Are we ready and willing to be clean? You got to have a willing spirit to ready to be willing to have your spirit cleansed by God. That's the only one that can wash you. When he tells you to wash yourselves, he's telling you to come to him and come to his court and confess so that he can cleanse your sins. God can wash you clean. But if you want to stay dirty, that's your choice. And don't sit here and say, I'll wait till next week. I got time. I'm going to hold this for a little longer. Praise the Lord. That's on you. But what if you die tomorrow? Oh, that's another something to think about right there.
Amen.
What if you die tomorrow? I ain't ready to die tomorrow. I'm going to tell you this. If you're not willing to repent, to let God cleanse you, this is what you're going to do. You're going to suffer at judgment. I'm going to tell you that right now. You need something to think about for real. If you ain't ready to do all these things, you are going to suffer at judgment. Don't be sitting there thinking, well, you know, I'll wait till when I get ready to die, I'm going to ask God to forgive me and all my sins. You're okay. He already told you he wasn't listening to you. You got to act in it now. So many people take God for granted, think that at the last moment, everything's good. And everything they've done is cleansed. The devil is a lie. And anybody telling you that is a lie. You got to do now. You got to clean up now. You got to get right with God now. Stop waiting. Stop being disobedient. Stop hating. Stop being angry. Stop carrying grudges. I don't want to see any of you hurt.
But I also don't want to see any of you being disobedient just because you just want to be. God's been too good to each and every one of us for us not to do the things that he requires of us to do. And it's not hard to follow the word of God. His word is so simplistic. Let me ask you something. Are we too proud to admit when we were wrong? Yeah, I know you are. You ain't got to say nothing to me. I can see it on your face. Are we too proud to forgive? Yeah, Pastor. Yeah, we are. Yeah. Are we too proud to come to God for help? Ah, here we go. Here you go. Now you ain't touching. You touching nerves. You touching nerves. We're all these things. Are we too proud to be submissive to God and do things His way? You feel about them other three? Let's concentrate on that last one. Are we too proud to be submissive to God and do things His way? It's time you stop doing things the way you want to do them. Christian folk. Saved. Sanctified. Full of the Holy Ghost folk. I think the Holy Ghost just walked out the door. You got to be ready. You got to start learning how to be submissive. We're too proud. We won't submit to no, we ain't submitting to nothing. That's just evil. Learn how to be submissive to God. Let me ask you something. Do we neglect the physically and spiritually poor and needy when we ourselves are proud, fool, and lazy? We do, don't we? Y'all know we do. From the pulpit to the door. Now I want y'all to think with me for a moment. Is this like anything like us today? Are we like that today? Like yesterday? All these things we talk about, just for a moment, just think about it. Is this anything like us today? Are we really like that? You can look at yourself and say, wow, that's me. I need to make a change. But how do I do it? You know, pastor sitting up here talking, but it ain't easier said than done. He make it sound so easy, but it's not that easy. Nobody said following God was going to be easy. Nobody said following his ways was going to be easy. Because he's going to put some obstacles in your course. He's going to put some people in your way, so you can hold a grudge, so you can be angry, so you can have malice in your heart. He's going to put that in your way to see if you're going to be obedient and follow his word. Don't you know that you got to stumble and fall before you can get up and succeed? And this thing we call life, nothing about it is easy. Life has something to throw at you each and every day. How many of y'all go to work and there's something already waiting for you? Amen. When you get there, it's always somebody that you don't like at work. Amen. You don't even want to see them when you get there. You hope they off. And if you're the boss, you're really in a bad mood, you just tell them, just take the day off. I really don't want to see you today. And you can send me home, because anytime I go home with pay. Who you hurt? You sure didn't hurt that individual. Think about some of these things. Why would you send somebody home with pay and think you done something? Now you got to take care of that person's that workload. So that's double work on you. They got the day off, chilling,
right,
with pay. But you did something. You thought you did something to them. You hurt them. I'm not gonna let you work here today. Mm-hmm. Okay. Can I have them one too? With pay. Man, I'm gonna tell you something. These the probably the best thing that the government did for me when they came up with telework. He's fine. He's fine. Don't worry about him. He's fine. And they came up with telework. And when they came over telework and they started telling us we could telework 3 days out of the week, no, my hand went up. They always teased me when I was teleworking, you know, you ain't got no job. You right, sure don't, but I get paid. I don't care what people say. You ain't got no job. You don't work. Sure don't. But I get paid. All I had to do, wake up in the morning, turn my computer on, put my card in, log in, go upstairs, get some coffee. You know I don't drink coffee, but I fake it. Eat me a donut, go downstairs, USA Today, SVU, Law and Order,
all right.
Marathon. Check in every now and then, check my email, back to SVU, baby. I miss teleworking. Amen. Where else you gonna get that kind of job where you stay at home and work and get paid? You can work in your pajamas. You ain't gotta go outside. When it's snow day, you ain't got to go outside. And then sometimes, you know, when people think they're doing something to you, tell you, just telework the rest of the week. Because you're angry with me, I did something, you know, you don't want to see my face. Praise the Lord. I'll take them 5 days. Look within yourself deeply and understand and realize that you need to repent, that you need to be cleansed, that the things that you're angry about, the people that you're angry with, nobody's being hurt but you. I don't care about the physicality. I'm talking about your spirituality. Your spirit is being damaged slowly. And only you can wash yourself clean. It's 2017, you all. And we all need a clean up. Amen.
Amen.
Emmanuel.
Amen.